Welcome to the third of the component modeler tutorials. In this tutorial, we will use two different primitives to form one leg. Afterwards, we will make reference copies from this leg. The dimensions of the tank can be found on the provided sheet drawing. We will now add the first leg to our tank. The leg consists of a vertical part and a ground plate. These are both rectangular. We will construct the vertical part using the sweep primitive. We will construct the ground plate using the piped primitive. The sweep primitive needs a start point, an end point, and a template shape. The piped primitive needs an origin point and length, width, and height dimensions. The coordinates of the points can be derived from the sheet drawing. Start the sweep primitive command under the Insert tab. Press C to open the coordinates panel. The start point needs to be at the center of the bottom of the rectangle. Type minus 600, minus 100 divided by 2 for x. Zero for y, and 15 for z. Press OK to accept the coordinates and left click to accept the start point. Press C to define the coordinates of the end point. Type minus 600, minus 100 divided by 2 for x, zero for y, and 850 plus 170 for z. Press OK to accept the coordinates and left click to accept the endpoint. You are now asked to select a shape out of a selection of templates. Select the rectangle. Enter the parameters for the rectangle. Width 100 and height 100. Press OK to accept the dimensions and press Enter to accept the primitive. For the ground plate, we will use the piped primitive. Start the command under the Insert tab. The origin point is located in the corner of the shape, with the dimensions expanding in the positive axial directions. Press C to open the coordinates panel. Type minus 600, minus 50. Minus 150 for x, minus 150 for y, and 0 for z. Press OK to accept the coordinates and left click to accept the origin point. Enter the dimensions for the ground plate. Length 300. Width 300 and height 15. Press OK to accept the values and press Enter to accept the primitive. Our next step is to create the other two legs from the existing one by using the reference copy function. Note that doing this creates referenced primitives. Altering the original primitive also alters its copies. Start by selecting the reference copy command under the Component Modeler tab. Select both the vertical part and the ground plates by intersecting the cursor hitbox with the primitives. When both parts are highlighted, press Enter to accept the selection. The program now asks for the origin point of the reference copy axis. For this, we use our base point. Move the cursor near the base point and press Q to lock the cursor. Left click to accept. We now need to define the direction of our reference copy axis. The legs are rotated around the Z axis. To choose this direction, right click, select Define Direction, and select Z-axis. Enter the following values. Distance between copies, 0. Rotation between copies 360 divided by 3. And number of copies 2. Press OK to accept the values and press Enter to accept the copies. Select the Show All function. The legs of the tank are now finished. Please continue to the next tutorial to proceed with the details of this tank.